Good morning, children. How are you? Welcome to Gautam Model School. And today we are going to start a new topic in the fourth class, that is plants surviving, living and surviving. Do you know, children, where are the plants? Plants are everywhere, and plants we can inhale the oxygen and give out the carbon dioxide. So plants are very, very essential to us. See, they are the reason for to breathe. Okay, and we cannot live without breathing, right? So plants are very, very essential. That's the reason every time we have to plant and grow more trees and plants. Okay, now there are different types of plants out there. Okay, so you can see that small short plants are there, big trees are there, even in the water also plants are there, right? So there are different types of plants are there in our environment. Okay, let us talk about the different types of plants. Okay, as you can see, plants are categorized into two categories. Okay, one is terrestrial and another one is aquatic. Okay, in the terrestrial, they are differentiated into five types. First one is leaf, next one is plains, next one is marshy, then hot and damp areas, and last one is deserts. Even in the aquatic, the plants are more like floating types of aquatic plants are there, then fixed plants are there, and then underwater plants are there. These are all aquatic. Aquatic means they are only growing in the water. Yes. Except this, more plants are there which are called as insectivorous plants. And one more type of plants, as we can see, they are in the forest. Okay, like Amazon forest is there. Okay, so they are only growing in the forest, and they are very essential to us. Okay, now let us start the chapter by doing a small exercise which are in your text paper. Okay, yes. See here, children. See here. Fill the blanks with the correct words from the brackets. You see the lotus plants where? In a pond, in a hill, or in a pot? You can find in a pot? No, you can find in a pond only. Okay, next. You can see mango trees where? In a pond you can see? Or in a hilly areas you can see? Hilly areas means there where the mountains are there. There you can see? No, you can see on the plains where so only soil is there. Na? There you can see the mango trees or peepal trees or papaya trees. They are all in the plains. Okay. Next. Right. You find coconut trees near where? In hilly areas, in the river, or near seaside. Where do you find the coconut trees? They are near the hot and damp areas like this Kerala, like the seaside, Bay of Bengal. There the coconut trees you can find. And they consume more water. They require more water to survive. Okay. So you cannot find them in the deserts. Okay. Last one. The rice plants give us what? Food, fiber, or firewood. So rice you eat, na? Every day you are eating the rice, right? So rice are a type of cereal plant. So it gives us food. Every day you are eating. So what you are eating, that is called as food, right? Now, coming to the terrestrial plants. Terrestrial plants, you can see they can find on the land. They can find in the hilly areas like mountains. And the best example is spruce trees, deodar, pine trees. And they are the shape of like cone trees, Ashoka tree, like this cone. So whenever the snow is falling down, it can be simply split off, like they can fall down on the ground. Okay, next one is and they have needle like leaves. Their needles are very sharp. Okay, sharp needle like trees are there. Okay, that is a pine tree. Did you see the pineapple? How it is very sharp. It's like a thorn. Yes, that is a pine trees. Yes, pine tree. Needle-like leaves are present on them. Okay. Next one is plains. Plains. I told you already that. Plain on the plains like papaya tree, peepal tree, mango tree. These all you find in the different on the land places. Okay, different places of the land. Okay, now this
I tell you. Okay.
This is what Nana. This is mango tree, and this is what beta banyan tree. You know the banyan tree is our national tree, and it can survive long years. Okay, so many years, and one of the most banyan tree which can in the north side of the India, and it can survive more than 1000 years ago. Okay, and the banyan tree has a very large branches. It can hang onto the ground, and it has so many roots in this. Okay, now this is about the plains which you can find on the trees. Okay, so these are the plains. Okay, next one is hot and damp areas. Do you know children, hot and damp areas, where are they? Near to the seaside, or near to the oceans, near to the ponds, near to that one. So they are they consume more water, like coconut tree and palm tree, teak tree. You can find a rubber trees and tea, coffee, sugar cane, and rice and paddy fields. They require more water. So they are grow only near to hot and damp areas. Okay. Next one is marshy areas. Marshy areas means it is with the combination of like water and sand, or water and land, and it is mixed. So what do you find? That mud. Okay, so where the mud you can find? It is like it's almost near to the riverside only, but sometimes what happen, the few plants are there which can grow above the sea level. Okay, and they are called as a mangroves, as you can see in this picture. See, in this picture, this is the cactus. Okay, later we will come into this. This is the mangrove. How you can see the roots are? The roots are coming out of the water. Okay, these are called as mangroves, or they are found in the marshy places where the mud is more, where the water and mud is more. There you can find this mangroves. Okay, next one is deserts. Desert, India has Thar desert, which is there in the Rajasthan, and the one of the largest desert is there in the Africa, and that desert is called as Sahara desert. Okay, so in the desert you can find this type of plants. This is cactus. You know, these cactus have spines. The leaves are modified into the spines. Okay, and they have thorns. Like thorns are also called as spines. Okay, they are modified leaves because they are consuming very less water. Like in the desert, you cannot find water in a high amount. Okay, so they can survive very little water. Okay, so they are, the leaves are modified into thorns, and you can see the stem is very green and fleshy. So that we can say that the photosynthesis process is going into because of this stem, because it is green and thick and fleshy. Okay, now coming to the aquatic plants. Aquatic plants are those plants which can survive and live in the water. Okay, either they can be above the water, either they can be underground the water, either they can be fixed. Okay, let us one by one conclude this, learn about the one by one aquatic plants. Okay, now first one is the floating plants. See how you can see the floating plants. Floating plants, see, these are duckweed. This is duckweed. Okay children, this is duckweed, and this one is water yancith. You can see like a flower type of is peeping outside the water, and in this also leaves are like with the roots, and they are peeping out of the water, right? These are called as floating plants, and even they can also do the photosynthesis with the help of the sunlight, the water they can consume from the water, okay, where they are living and surviving, okay. And they are very small in size. I think you have seen when you are going here and there in the river or seaside or pond, few are very spreading shape, and they have the stem is inside them, okay. They are floating plants, okay. So in the example is the duckweed and the yancey, okay. Now fixed plant, do you know the yes ma'am.
Unit 2. Flora and Fauna. Types of plants. These are different kinds of plants. Plants are classified on the basis of size, lifespan, place of growth and flowering pattern. Types of plants on the basis of their size. Trees are plants with a long stem supporting branches and leaves. They are big in size and have a thick brown stem called the trunk. Common trees in your neighborhood are neem, banyan, chiku, gulmohar, mango and amaltas. Shrubs and bushes are smaller than trees. A shrub is distinctly different from a tree due to its shorter, thinner brown stem. Small shrubs are often termed as bushes. Fatsia japonica, jasmine, shoe flower and pistachio are shrubs. Lavender, periwinkle are bushes. Plants can be of different sizes. The green grass in the garden can also grow up to 30 meter high. The bamboo plant is one such example. Herbs are small plants with soft and green stems. They are used to flavor food, medicine or perfume. Basil, that is tulsi, coriander, oregano, mint, grass and flowers like balsam are a few common herbs. Creepers and climbers cannot stand erect as they have tender and green stems. Creepers grow along the ground. Melon, bottle gourd, pumpkin are some creepers. Climbers take support and climb walls, poles and tree trunks. Grapevine, pea and money plant are some climbers. Types of plants on the basis of lifespan. Animal plants are plants that have a lifespan of 1 year or a life cycle that completes in one season. They grow, bear fruits and seeds and then die. That is, they complete their life cycle within this duration. Wheat, rice, peas, coriander, marigold, beans, etc. are annual plants. Biennial plants have a life cycle that spans two seasons. In the first season, the plant grows and stores food, and in the second season, it bears flowers, fruits, seeds, and then dies. Beet, cabbage, celery, lettuce, carrots are biennial plants. Perennial plants are plants that grow for more than two seasons or 2 years. Most of the trees come under this category. Mango tree, coconut tree, neem tree, banyan tree are perennial plants. Types of plants on the basis of their place of growth. Terrestrial plants. Plants that grow on land are called terrestrial plants. The plants growing in your gardens are terrestrial plants like mango, neem, and coconut trees. Plants that grow in deserts have swollen stems. Their leaves are in the form of spines as a response to the harsh weather conditions. Cactus, prickly pear are some common plants. Aquatic plants. Plants that grow in water are called aquatic plants. Lotus and water lily are aquatic plants. Plants growing in different areas need structural modification to survive in those conditions. Types of plants on the basis of their flowering pattern. Plants can also be classified as flowering plants and non-flowering plants on the basis of their flowering pattern. Flowering plants are ones that produce flowers and bear fruits. Hibiscus, also known as shufla, rose plant and balsam, are flowering plants. Non-flowering plants are those that do not produce flowers. Algae, ferns, mosses, etc. are non-flowering plants.